Hey everyone, it's Caitlin and welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make some vegan monkey bread. If you've never heard of monkey bread before, it is a traditionally very indulgent breakfast dish in which you chop up some frozen biscuits, throw them in a bundt pan, and then top them with a lot of butter, sugar, and cinnamon. Now obviously, my version is going to be vegan, but it's also going to be slightly healthier as well, as this entire recipe is oil-free and free of refined sugars, but guys, it still tastes so good. I brought it to a potluck and everyone loved it. This video is also a collaboration with my friends Jasmine and Chris of Sweet Simple Vegan. As you guys know, we team up on a monthly basis to bring you guys delicious vegan recipes. The theme you all voted for this month was a holiday breakfast idea, so after you finish watching this video, head on over to Jasmine and Chris's channel to see them make some vegan strata, which is typically a quiche stuffed with bread, sausage, and a bunch of other yummy things. They're going to veganize it and it looks amazing. Also, don't forget to vote on the theme of our next collaboration right up here in your screen. We are between a 30-minute meal and a slow cooker recipe. So that's all I have to say for now. Let's get to baking. Okay, so first up, we're going to be making the dough for our monkey bread. And to start out, we're going to add some active dry yeast and some warm water into a bowl. Then we're just going to cover this with some coconut sugar. If you'd rather use a different granulated sugar, that is fine as well. But you're just going to add that into the warm water and then let the yeast and the sugar activate together and let it sit for about 3 to 5 minutes until the yeast is fully bloomed. Then we're going to mix together some flour with some cinnamon and salt. And the cinnamon just adds a little bit of extra cinnamony goodness to our dough. So then after that is mixed, we're going to be adding some vanilla extract and some nut butter back into the yeast mixture. And the nut butter here is working in place of an oil, so it's still going to make our dough nice and moist without the use of an added oil, but we'll still get some of those healthy fats in there. So we're just going to mix that together until it's pretty evenly incorporated and dissolved. Then we're going to add in our dry mix to our wet mix and then mix it together. And I find it easiest just to do this in increments. So as you can see, that's what I did here. And eventually it's going to get a little bit too sticky to use a fork with. So you can just knead the dough with your hands and keep adding in flour. I used about 4 cups in total. And then afterwards, you're going to knead your dough for about 5 to 10 minutes just to help activate the gluten in it so it will become nice and fluffy. And yep, you just keep adding in flour until the dough is moist and a little bit sticky but doesn't stick to your fingers when you touch it. So then you're just going to rinse out that bowl that you mixed everything together in, plop your kneaded dough in, and then cover it with a towel and let it sit in a warm place for about an hour until it doubles in size. In the meantime, we can make our cinnamon dressing or glaze that's going to go on top of the monkey bread by using some maple syrup or another liquid sweetener, as well as some plant-based milk, and again, a little bit more nut butter. We're also going to add some cinnamon and then mix this together. And realistically, for this recipe, you can use any nut butter you'd like, but keep in mind that this is going to affect the final flavor of the recipe. So for that reason, I would recommend either almond butter or cashew butter. You can also use sunflower seed butter if you have a nut allergy. But as you can see, our dough has risen here. So I'm just flouring my surface, plopping the dough out and kneading it together just a little bit more. And now we're going to make our dough balls. So you're going to take about a tablespoon sized piece of dough and roll it together in your hands until it forms a ball. And this is going to expand once it bakes in the oven. So that's why we want our dough balls to be pretty small to begin with. So we're just going to keep making balls until all of our dough has disappeared or been transformed into balls, and we're going to line them into a bundt pan. I'm using a silicone bundt pan so I didn't have to grease it with oil, but if you're just using a regular bundt pan, you're going to need to add a little bit of oil just so it doesn't stick. Then from there, we're going to pour about 3/4 of our sauce over the monkey bread. And as you can see, I actually ended up blending my sauce together just to make it a little bit more smooth and creamy. Just for reference, I reserved about a third of a cup of it off to the side. We're going to be using this later. But from there, we're just going to plop our monkey bread into the oven. It's going to bake for between 20 and 25 minutes, and it should come out looking a little bit something like this. So to start out, you want your monkey bread to sit in the pan for about 10 minutes. This allows the dough balls to kind of harden and stick to each other a little bit more. And then from there, you can flip it onto a plate and hopefully it will come out perfectly like mine did and not stick to the pan at all. Then from here, this is where we're going to drizzle it with the remaining third cup of sauce that we reserved. Just spread it around evenly, and you can even use a spatula to spread it along the sides just to make sure everything is evenly coated and all of the monkey bread is nice and moist and cinnamony. And then to make things even more extra, I decided to drizzle some icing sugar on top. If you want to keep this refined sugar free, you could also use some melted coconut butter or even some vegan yogurt as well. But that is it for this recipe. It's super easy but super satisfying, and I really hope you guys try it out. And there you have it. As always, I will have the full recipe linked below in the description box. And if you are into that whole Pinterest thing, I will have a link to my Pinterest page as well in case you want to save it later that way. Don't forget to check out Jasmine and Chris's video for some delicious vegan strata. And let me know in the comments below what you're planning on making for your holiday breakfast. Or I guess what someone else in your family is planning on making for you. If this is your first time seeing one of my videos and you like what you see here, feel free to hit that little subscribe button right down there. I normally post 2 new videos every single week, and they're always easy and delicious vegan recipes, so, you know, who doesn't like that? All right, that is officially everything I have to say, so thank you all so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will talk to you later. Bye!